Hello, my name is Simon Head, and I'm the Business Development Manager for SAP Analytics Cloud at Coldstone Group. Today, I'm going to show you a smart predict on SAP Analytics Cloud. The smart predict scenario we're going to show you today is around customer payment forecasting. We're asking SAC or SAP Analytics Cloud to answer three questions. We're going to take a file of open invoices and we're going to ask, based on the history in the system, what customers are likely to pay late, when are they likely to pay, and which customers must be prioritized for payment collecting. The objective here is to allow our debt management teams to chase the invoices which are at greatest risk of not being paid and are of the highest value. So it's effectively helping our debt collection teams. So what we go through in creating a smart predict model in SAP Analytics Cloud, around six stages. Stage one, we've loaded the historical invoice data from S4HANA, BYD, or Business One, or any ERP system into SAC. And then we're going to create a predictive scenario or predictive model in SAC, and we're going to track the quality of our predictive model. So effectively, we load the history of the invoices into the system, and the system now understands which systems are late, which invoices have been paid late, which invoices are paid time, and understands the dimensions such as the services, where the cash discount has been applied, and the vendor, the customer which has been paying late. Once we've created our predictive model, we then load all open invoices into the system. So all invoices which haven't yet been paid and aren't due for payment. And we're basically asking SAC to tell us, out of these open invoices which have been loaded, what customers are likely to pay late, when are they likely to pay, and this will allow our collection team to focus on the high-risk invoices. In the demonstration today, for the sake of time, we're just going to show a dashboard where we see those predictions made from Smart Predict. So I'm quickly going to show the data set, which is loaded, and this has all the history. So our services, our invoice date, our due date, and the payment date, i.e. when it was paid. So this is all the history which has been loaded into the system. Just scroll down to the bottom. You can see in this example, there's 44,000 invoices recorded. So we've loaded and created a smart predict model. Now what we're doing is looking at the output. So we've created a dashboard, and here's a dashboard of that historical data. And we can see that the customer is on the left-hand side, and these are showing all the payments which have been made into the system. And just running the slider up and down, and go back to 2017 into 2020, I can select a single supplier like ICE Networks or a single service, and I can analyze the payment profile. And in the table below, I can see whether ICE Networks has paid the invoice on time and when the payment was made. So this is all the history. From this, we created a predictive model. So the second stage of our predictive model is that we load all the unpaid invoices into the system, and we ask the system to predict whether these will be paid late or on time. So £64 million of unpaid invoices, 5,000 invoices, and we can see in solution build, the system is saying that the solution build service, 13 million or 14 million of invoices will be paid late. So let's focus on one supplier. And then we come down into the table, one customer, we can see Pixie Limit, and the late payments by probability value. So we've listed all the invoices value, and then the model said there's a 73% chance of this invoice being paid late, which gives it a probability value of 48,000. So these are the high risk invoices which will be paid. Clicking on it, we can see that same invoice has got a high value with a high probability, whereas these 100% ones, lower value. So let's just look at solution build as a service. And now we can help target our AR teams to chase these debts down, to chase the ones with the highest probability and the highest value, and try and get these payments in early. So this is an aid to our accounts receivable teams in their debt management. So the orange is 73% probability, blue is around the 60s, and finally we've got the red, which are 100%. So this has told us what invoices will be paid late. Now we're looking at when they will be paid late. So how many days they'll be late, and the date at which they're expected to be paid. So this can help with our cash flow forecasting, but also is a different way of tracking our outstanding debt. Okay, at the moment, there's too much data, too many blue charts. So what I'm going to do is focus on one. But looking on this heat map, clicking on ICE Networks, I can see that the amount is 3.294. So I'm just going to click on ICE Networks. And again, I'm not interested in the invoices which will be paid on time, which are all at the bottom, not days late. So I'm going to change my slider up to maybe a 14. And just focus on the invoices which will be paid late. And again, I'm interested in the higher value amounts, so I'll just increase my invoice amount. And now I've really got my problem invoices for ICE Networks. These are the number of days late, and these are the values, and I can see the individual invoice number, and these are the ones that I can chase, but chase down and understand why they're getting paid late. Okay, so this concludes the demonstration on payment forecasting, so that we can understand the payment profile and help our account our debt management teams chase down debt. And these are just some of the other examples of Smart Predict. We're not predicting values as such, we're more predicting outcomes. So for example, customer profiling. Who are my top customers? How much will they spend? Which customers are likely to reduce their spending? Or employee churn management. Which employments are likely to leave? What is the profile of the employee that leaves? And how much would it cost to recruit replacements? I hope this is helpful. But this scenario has shown how you can use historical data sets to predict future outcomes. Thank you very much.